Guys, we got a lot to talk about today. The first of which is the new format. Once a week, I'll be doing this free video newsletter for you guys who have subscribed to my blog, and we'll cover a brief topic that has something to do with marketing or business, something along those lines. Definitely educational and informational still. I just have found it's much easier for me to record it and then pass it off to somebody to make magic and get it on the internet than it is for me to sit there and type it all out. If you want to get involved in the Gentleman's Club and actually join, there are some very titillating videos waiting for you on the other side where we cover anything and everything that you need in order to grow your business, to learn about marketing yourself effectively, personal branding. We talk about anything that has to do with you being rich and successful, guaranteed to make you more attractive to the ladies. So if you want to join the Gentleman's Club, you can do so by clicking on BigCheeseMarketing.com and hitting the button that says Join the Gentleman's Club. I will warn you, it is PG-13 to be sure, but you are definitely going to have a good time and learn a lot in the process. Okay, business talk out of the way. I got to be honest with you guys about something. Today, I'm pissed off. Just a little. Here's what happened. I was at the gym on the treadmill. And for whatever reason, my MP3 player decided today's the day, not going to work. So I'm making do with the videos that are playing, and there's like CNN and Fox and a couple other things. And I happen to see this headline while I'm on the treadmill. And it talks about, it was like Shepherd or one of those guys on Fox talking about how this woman decided that after she had gone to college in New York, that it was the school's responsibility to get her a job, and since they had not followed through with what they said they were going to do, she's now suing them for $70,000. So the rest of my workout, needless to say, I'm fuming. I'm seriously pissed off. So I come home and I hop on the internet and I find out this woman has paid $70,000 to go to this school in New York, and she's upset because the Office of Career Advancement, which is a division of the school, has not done enough to advance her career since she graduated. And she says she gave it a good college try, but wasn't able to find a job on her own, and it was the school's responsibility to find one for her, and they had not done this. Get this. She graduated in April of this year. Yeah, April. It's now August, April. So obviously not looking too terribly hard and probably being a bit picky, because it would be very easy to find a job where all you got to do is say, hey, would you like fries with that? Now, I'm not one to point out the turd in the punch bowl, but it looks like I'm going to have to this time, okay? The fact of the matter is that this woman is creating a lawsuit to where she thinks, number one, she's getting $70,000 back. That ain't happening, because most of it's going to go to the attorney. Number two, if this goes to trial and she sits in front of a jury of her peers, who do you think those peers are? They're going to be like-minded employee mentality, average working Joes that also couldn't get off from their job except to get jury duty, right? Business owners, people who are a bit more influential, can usually get out of jury duty with a legitimate excuse. I mean, you know, there's a lot of people that answer to you, blah, blah, blah. So the jury is going to be of her peers. So they're going to find in favor of the school. Poor, pitiful school now owes her $70,000, which she probably got from some kind of Pell Grant or something that she's got to pay back. So... and that ain't going to happen either. I think she'll take the money and run. At any rate, the biggest tragedy in all of this, in my opinion, lies with the school. Bet you didn't see that coming, did you? Why does it lie with the school? For the simple fact that if it was going to be a business school, rather than training her to be a secretary or an administrative assistant or filing bitch or whatever you want to call it, rather than training her to be that, they could have had a course in entrepreneurship, where they actually taught her how to not get a job, but create one for herself. you know, that she could actually create her own business since it's a business school, and therefore she wouldn't need to worry about anything else. She wouldn't have to worry about going to someone with her hand out with that entitlement mentality that she's got, saying, "Where is my paycheck?" You remember what Robert Kiyosaki says? "Where is my paycheck?" W-I-M-P. Wimp. So the school, in my opinion, is at fault for not teaching her how to become her own boss, how to start her own business. She is at fault on so many levels, I don't even want to go there, and it's left me pissed off the rest of the day. But I tell you what, I'm getting ready to do my video newsletter for this month for the Peep Show. And you know what we're going to talk about first? My good buddy Timmy V. My good buddy Timmy G, not Timmy V. Timmy G. Tim Geithner. Oh, I love this man. He gives me so much fodder, so much to talk about. So we're going to talk about Tim Geithner and his illustrious plan to save the economy by paying down the deficit. Yeah, that one was well thought through. You're going to learn some things about Geithner that you did not know, that you did not know, that you didn't know. And you're probably going to learn some things about the economy, too, that's going to help grow your business. And that's what we're here for, right? So go ahead, join the Gentleman's Club if you haven't already. You can leave a comment on this or any other video newsletter that we do. And I'm looking forward to seeing you next week.